It took me 1 year to develop this product. In 2022, there was a year-long period where I didn't post any videos. That's because of this thing. The Magnus MKII is a thread shooting watch product that I developed in college. I made it because I wanted to offer people something that can shoot and reload thread electronically while having the look and feel of a normal watch. Well, maybe not normal, but as close to it as possible. I thought making this would take like 3 months tops. I was very wrong. Here's why. CNC machining. It's a manufacturing process that produces beautiful results. I mean, look at this stuff. But it comes at a price, literally. CNC machine parts are expensive. These are some early prototype parts for Magnus. If these parts were 3D printed, the price per part would be around $7. With CNC machining, that cost jumps to $350 each. Because of this high price, I looked for cheaper CNC machining services. And I eventually found one, but the reason they were cheaper was because they took a long time to make the parts. Because of that, the time between ordering parts and receiving them was around 1 month. Given that I had to do multiple rounds of prototyping, this meant I had to wait multiple months for parts. Not great. But wait, there's more. There's another problem with making products out of metal, the finish. Parts straight off of the CNC machine don't look particularly good. That's why we have to do extra stuff to the parts to make them look nicer and make them suitable for everyday use. The finish I settled on? CNC machined 6061 T6 aluminum with a 0.8 roughness average, deburred, sandblasted with 220 grit, and then type 2 anodized to Pantone 8001C. Before deciding on these specs, I tried out a bunch of different finishes, with each set of samples costing, you guessed it, a lot of time and money. If this was a one-off project, it wouldn't have taken so long. But since this is a product, I needed to make sure everything was just right and spec'd correctly for the manufacturer, so that the quality remains consistent as we scale up production. The CNC machine parts, however, were only one of the many reasons this product took a while to develop. The electronics were another reason. We designed a custom PCB for the electronic reloading, but that meant I had to find someone to manufacture that custom PCB. Luckily, I knew about JLC PCB, who also happened to be the sponsor of this video. JLC PCB is a solid PCB and PCB assembly provider. I've been using them for 4 years now, and they never disappoint. They're super affordable, starting at just $2. Yep, $2 for custom boards. Their service is reliable, and their website is easy to use. Just upload your Gerber files, choose your settings, and you're good to go. They're quick too. Since they do everything in-house, I've had PCBs made in as quick as 24 hours. As a full manufacturing solution, they also offer PCB customization services, component sourcing, stencil manufacturing, 3D printing, CNC machining, and more. Back when I was developing the Magnus MKII, JLC PCB didn't offer CNC machining services, but as of June 2023, they do. I wish they offered CNC services sooner, since the quotes I'm getting from JLC PCB are literally 10 times cheaper than the other quotes I got in the past, with turnaround times as fast as 5 days instead of a month. If you want to try out JLC PCB, click my link in the description to get $70 in free coupons. Thanks JLC PCB for sponsoring this video. After getting PCBs from JLC PCB, there were still two problems I had to grapple with for the electronics. The first problem was the motor. I wanted to use this motor for the reload mechanism, but the shaft was too short and caused everything to wobble. I needed the same motor with a longer shaft, which took me a long, long time to source as it was pretty unique. The second problem was with the battery. I ended up using custom batteries as nothing available off the shelf met the spec we needed. However, if you want to sell products with LiPo batteries, especially if you're shipping them overseas, they need a clear safety certification like UL1642 and UN38.3. So we had to contract with a battery manufacturer to get custom batteries, and then get those custom batteries independently safety certified by a lab. This took quite some time. Besides this, there were more problems. With 3D printing, parts can easily press fit together. However, metal is much less flexible and forgiving than plastic. So I ran into issues trying to make the cartridge slide in and stay securely. After iterating on a lot of designs, I designed this compliant mechanism with a perfect amount of friction and staying power. But again, this took time. The theme here is that making a product is a lot harder and time-consuming than making a one-off project. Once you think about selling something, you have to think about manufacturing, quality control, safety certifications, fulfillment logistics, supply chains, product photography, product videography, packaging, customer experience, etc. These things take time to figure out. To top it all off, I was still a full-time college student studying engineering and doing an internship and battling a few health issues. So yeah, developing this product took a lot longer than I expected. It's one of the reasons why I've decided to focus on making more projects now and making more videos, because honestly, it's just a lot more fun and it's a lot faster. And I get to share new projects with you all much more frequently. As usual, all the files for Magnus are freely available for 48 hours after this video goes live. Link in the description. After 48 hours, the files are only available to HeroTech members. I've also done a really limited restock of the Magnus Mark II, so if you want to get one for yourself, you can head over to our website at herotech.engineering. However, I am developing a new thread shooting technology that's going to be even better. Two of the things I didn't like about the Magnus is that the thread is really thin and the electronic reload takes a while. I'm working to improve both of those things. Stay tuned because I'm hoping to finish that by the end of this year. Thanks for watching.